As we had in the past, we are going to take a look inside of the Italian pavilion, tasting new products, meeting old and new friends. So let's go inside and check it out.
We want to be in the high-end kind of products. We don't want to compete with the supermarkets or this kind of stuff. So we are very well positioned in the high level of products. No, we have Agrimontana, as you can see over here. We have already a nice selection of products.
New products, really particular, con la Tura di Alici.
Yes, absolutely. This is a product that now is about a year that we brought in. We have been using Colatura for a number of years. But this is really now the top of the line that we really enjoy, the chefs enjoy very much.
Yeah, and I really love like the packaging and how it's like the display.
Yes, absolutely. It's a great product. No, the packaging is nice. No, the people that produce is excellent.
In anchovy sauce is a special method. We do keep it 2 years seasoning in a chestnut barrel. And after that, we drill a little hole underneath the barrel and we collect this sauce. You can use that sauce like instead of the salt. It has a very high content of proteins and it's very healthy because it's natural. So you can use every dish. Now we have a mozzarella cheese. It's a very light cheese. And we use it as a condiment.
Wow, sounds magic.
Yeah.
From Sara Farmartino, New York, a story about Del Verde Pasta.
So basically we are trying to bring here the credibility of a brand. So today is a lot of meaning is coming from making the consumer living an experience and providing them content. And we have a lot of content because our pasta is made only with spring water, coming from a source that is coming from a river. The name is Verde. Our company name is Del Verde, means green. The color of the packaging is Verde. So we have a lot of things within this wellness trend worldwide that is becoming more and more important. So, and within this new trend, we are trying to build some new pasta, like the pasta with the chickpeas and with the flax seeds. We are the first one producing this kind of pasta, and is still a gourmet product. So you have the bite, the al dente pasta, and is 70% durum wheat semolina and 30% flour from chickpeas and 24% flour from flax seeds. And we always say that this is the right answer to the wellness more than the gluten-free, because gluten-free is good for who has the sickness, but is no good because there's no gourmet, has no bite for the people that think to eat better because they just eat gluten-free. In reality, if you want to eat better, there are much more choices, like the legumes. And this year UNESCO declared that is the year of the legumes. So that's why we jump on board and we create this new variety, penne and fusilli, with flax seeds and chickpeas.
I see a lot of interest, especially for the Italian products. So I think it's a great opportunity for Italian producer to market their product here in the United States. Very nice.
What are you like doing today? Just like with the coffee booth?
Yes, correct. We help each Italian pavilion with the welcoming, with the characteristic of Italy, one of the most famous, let's say, things, drink of Italy, the coffee. And so far we served over 5,000 espresso and cappuccino in less than 2 days.
Come sta andando?
Ringrazio pubblicamente l'Italian Trade Commission che mi ha incaricata di promuovere quelle che sono le tipicità e le eccellenze italiane. Per me è un grande onore rappresentare qui a New York al Summer Fancy Food, e la cosa più bella è che a partecipare con me lo chef Marco D'Amico. Sono 20 anni oltre che a New York, ma è di Vasto, quindi non solo abruzzese ma è vastese. Abbiamo fatto il pacchero con il ragù tradizionale italiano, quindi un un ragù di carne mista con pomodoro, tutta la selezione dal pomodoro, dal formaggio, dagli oli, la selezione di prodotti italiani. E poi invece abbiamo una carne che adesso ti presenta Marco, che è stato un grande successo.
Abbiamo un agnello brasato con raviola cheese, abbiamo fatto una salsa di mirtilli con balsamico, vino rosso e arancia. È ridotta, così col casto del formaggio e lo sweet and sour del vino rosso abbiamo fatto una combinazione che andava con l'agnello ovviamente.
Pomì è un marchio del Consorzio Casalasco del Pomodoro, che è una grande cooperativa, la prima filiera del pomodoro in Italia. La gamma prodotti è composta da diverse tipologie, quindi abbiamo le polpe, le passate, il tomato sauce, e proprio qui in occasione del Fancy Food abbiamo presentato la nuova linea per del pomio organic. Ma senz'altro noi siamo molto soddisfatti e anno dopo anno abbiamo sempre visto dei numeri in crescita. Riteniamo che il completamento con questa linea organic possa dare una ulteriore risposta a quello che è un consumatore sempre più attento ed esigente.
We've been at Fancy Food now for many, many years. That's the third year with Terra Ducali and all the group that you see around. This year is more interesting than the other ones because I'm noticing a changement into especially the Italians. Like Italian companies are finally getting together. What I'm noticing at this show, especially this year, is the fact that a lot of booths put themselves together. There are no barriers. They're not just single booths. They're putting down the walls. They're getting together to basically use several products, cross-market them to showcase the American population, basically all the different way to use products. Sometimes we were very limited. In my opinion, you're just selling a single product and don't show application. It's very important to show application. I think this year they're doing a better job, and especially you see the producers that are definitely more into the American market, what the market wants. So finally, we are bringing our Italian expertise, knowledge, quality of products, and try to place it beside authentic American recipes and way of living and of cooking. So to make it successful, everybody.
What we have here?
Oh, well, as we said, this is like the big news for us, for the shows, in terms of Italian salumi. Salami has been approved, so we got the big selection. We are hopefully in 6 months we're gonna have other short cure salumi like coppa and then pancetta, guanciale, culatello. For the moment it's just the salami, but we are happy to showcase finally 6, 7, 8 different qualities. What you see here is the stroghino IGP from Parma. You got a pelino salami, and you got a couple of flavor ones. This one is with olives and this one with chili pepper. So we're making the American try the salami. They're used to usually hard salami, so that's not the style that usually the American try it. They're a little insecure because they are very soft compared to their standards, but when they try, they understand the quality of the meat. And we always say, well, especially the stroghino is made out of meat of culatello, so you want to try the sweetness of the prosciutto, and you have to try the way it is, so soft and nice. Stroghino in Italy is a salami that the kids eat, so that's the deliciousness. And they are buying into it. When you explain, it needs a lot of education, but they're buying into it.
You apply like the same concept to the cheese as well, right?
Absolutely, yes. Like you see, like for example, like we got Osella, that has been an historical company since the 60s in Italy, and they all are so proud about their branding, but they understand very well that for the American market, you need a bigger package, bigger portion, very big distinction of colors. So everybody's doing their job. They like to put the 1860, so that the age of the foundation. So it's amazing how everybody, as I said before, they're trying to apply to this market to really have an impact and work more together. I think that's the really big news of this Fancy Food Show.
L'idea è nata appunto noi siamo un'azienda che facciamo cannoli da più di 20 anni, e qualche anno fa è nata un'azienda a noi vicina che ha messo appunto questa crema di ricotta fresca, non surgelata, con una shelf life abbastanza lunga che permetteva di portare il prodotto all'estero, e quindi è nata l'idea di preparare un kit in modo da dare a tutti la possibilità di avere il cannolo fresco come ce l'abbiamo noi in Sicilia.
We have a quite large range that we try to introduce to our final buyers. But let's say that the new is this pack, this cube, that is called the Tetra Ricard, that is the novelty on the market for the simple reason that it's got, according to the American way of consuming this product, a kind of monoportion offer that we make, because we are observing that the Americans are changing their way to consume the Italian products in general, because the families are getting smaller and smaller. So the quantity of product they consume for a single recipe is less than in the past. So there is a particular interest in products that has got smaller volumes in terms of offer.
How about the buyers and the people stopping buying today at the fancy food?
Buyers are always a nightmare for whoever wants to sell the products, because in USA there has always been a logic of Italian sounding products, but not really Italian. We try to sell the real Italian brand. The Cirio is 160 years old brand, and because of that, obviously we try to keep the quality level standards at the top levels, and sometimes for the buyers it's difficult to understand such price difference because it's due to the level of quality we sold to them. So it's an hard job, but they come and they are interested, they want to understand more about it.
Il Napadano, come sappiamo, non è solo buono, ma è anche salutare. Questo gli americani lo sanno?
Beh, quello che stiamo cercando di spiegare e di dire, abbiamo presentato anche recentemente, il mese scorso, una ricerca importante che è stata presentata proprio qui a New York in occasione del congresso mondiale dell'ipertensione, dalla quale si dimostra che un'assunzione giornaliera costante di una dose che sta fra i 30 e i 50 grammi di rana padano di 12 mesi abbassa il livello della pressione, che è l'esatto contrario di quello che si è tendenzialmente portati a pensare a carico dei latticini. Quindi il nostro lavoro di costruzione di una cultura sull'agroalimentare sta continuando. Questo è il nostro intento, il tentativo che facciamo, e devo dire che i numeri tutto sommato ci danno ragione, perché di anno in anno vediamo che l'export continua. Sappiamo però che modificare le abitudini alimentari di un popolo è un'operazione culturale di educazione costante che deve essere fatta in modo minuzioso, che ha bisogno dei suoi tempi, e quindi con la costanza e la perseveranza di sempre noi ogni anno continuiamo.
Sperlari is one of the most known food brands in Italy, so it's not only the product, it's let's say the history behind it, the tradition, the passion for taste, which is somehow representing a little bit the Italian way of life, so it's a little bit more than the product itself. We are actually presenting, of course, the traditional Sperlari line. This year we are also showcasing some other historical brands of the Italian market. One is Galatine. My generation has been growing with that. It's actually milk in your pocket. That's the claim that we use since the 70s for this product. And then we have some other propositions which are still produced in our Italian factories, but the interesting thing is that when also American people who don't know about Torrone stop by and taste our Torroncini, they love it.
Ferrarini is one of the leaders in Italy of production of cold cuts and Parmigiano. Ferrarini is a company founded almost 100 years ago in Italy and is still private owned. and we import everything made in Italy, made in our production plant. As we can see, or we will see, we produce many different kind of cold cuts and Parmigiano Reggiano. Something that is very interesting, I think, to show to the public is that this that you see here, this villa, is actually our headquarter. Is where we start to produce prosciutto cotto, and where is still produce the prosciutto cotto, and we have our headquarter. Ferrarini is a family that is coming from farms. They own a lot of, and as you see, everything here is authentic from our production plant. Something very important to know about the Ferrarini that was born with the prosciutto cotto. The Parmigiano Reggiano production. Parmigiano Reggiano production that is very particular because is of course is a product that is manufactured in the area of Reggio Emilia. And what is very different from Ferrarini that Ferrarini own 8 different farms. So Ferrarini is able to control the production of the cheese starting from the feeding of the animals. So we control the feeding. We have our own cows, and we produce also the butter made with the cream from the same milk. So we import, and we are able to import a cheese that is made with, you know, authenticity and in the same way that has been produced for many centuries.
Fiasconaro oggi viene negli Stati Uniti e scommette con un prodotto che è nordico, non siciliano, e viene fuori qualcosa di magico.
Fantastico.
Sembrava una cosa incredibile quando quasi 30 anni fa da ragazzetto iniziavo a farle il panettone, oggi ci troviamo a venderlo ai meneghini, ai trevigiani e in tutto il mondo mettiamo la nostra bandierina.
So you have a long tradition in the field of baking and bakery, right?
Yes, just like the Fiasconaro family, the Settepani family, we've been here in New York for over 43 years now, and basically what we've been doing all these years is keeping the tradition. Just like the Fiasconaro is doing in Italy, we're doing here in New York. As an ambassador of Italian food, Italian savory sweets, and just like Mr. Fiasconaro does his panettone in Sicily, we have our own production of panettone here in New York, and we are probably few of the ones that really do their own production, just like artisanal way of doing panettone. Listen, to me, tradition and family is everything. So if you take that away, there's nothing left. So I'm proud. I have 3 kids that are all 3 of them in the business, and hopefully they're going to continue the tradition of bringing Italian food to New York and to hopefully other places outside of New York. And this is what we do. We love this. You know, this work.
Yeah, because you have location all over New York, Staten Island, and so it's like a good sign.
Yes, I mean, it's always, for us, it's always, we always get the itch to open up another place here, another place there, and just because we want to send our product to more places in New York, you know.